Okay, I was taking a break from my work and just, sticking in some extra verses in Peter. This is still 1 Peter. I'm going to put this into PDF format, and there will be a link in the video description. But it's still, just a temporary document because I'm not bothering to translate it yet in meter. I'm sorry if I sound funny. I'm crying my eyes out because I'm in such a state of shock. I really don't know why God's allowing me to live or know this. I'm sorry. I shouldn't be allowed to know this and live. Okay, I've got to get. I'm sorry. Let me get control. I was just pacing and counting the syllables. And as you can see, they are parsed now into clauses. And you can argue maybe that the way I parse the clause could be changed. But in any event, the syllables still count the way they do. And unless you can come up with something that invalidates it, and I would welcome that. This looks like what the right answer is, and the right answer is extremely shocking. Where we left off was, I'm sorry, I'm just going to have to keep trying to talk. Where we left off was verse 3. And you'll notice that these are divisible by 7 in each verse, but the total is not. So I highlighted it in green to show that it's actually divisible by 5. And so then I pasted in verses 4, and there's your syllable count. We got some crasses here. I'm sorry. We got some crasses here. And there's no elision that I can see in here. There's no elision that I can see in here. Now, you might be able to argue that verse 4 is not really the end of it syntactically. But the fact of the matter remains that the clause ends here. Paul does the same thing. And what's so shocking to me that I'm having trouble talking is the syllable count here at 231. 231 is the number of syllables that God used to reply to Daniel. In Daniel, I'm sorry, Daniel 9, 24 through 27, which is a decree about the 490, which was precisely what Paul was explaining, is that church gets a new 490, and Paul is dating that 490 from Christ's birth, which was a surprise to me because I expected him to date it from Christ's death. Now, when Paul did his meter, which is right here, when Paul did his own meter, see, he did some anaphora, and the anaphora are extremely sophisticated. There are 3 of them. They all intersect to explain benchmarks in the history of the coming apostasy of church. That's the whole theme of his meter, to explain why the rapture will become progressively less likely as time goes on. And he specifically bases the meter on Daniel 9, 24 through 27, which is God's reply to Daniel. God's reply to Daniel is 231 syllables. Mary plays on this by deleting 14 syllables to say that the 14-year overage is still in abeyance when she writes. Paul is completing the 14. Okay? So he's saying this is how the 14's going to get done. In other words, church is going to be the bridge back to the tribulation. And where he gets that, and this is what's so shocking about it, is that each year of here, each of these syllables is actually standing, and I can't account for why. Each of these years, think of this as AD, think of this as 215 AD, 222 AD, 231 AD. And 231 AD, he benchmarks as vote short, there's going to be a tribulation, as it were, for church, because thlipsis has two meanings, generic and specific. And church is in its own tribulation right now. This is why the preterists get so confused, because there is that theme in the Bible. The church is going through its own tribulation now, just as when Christ was down here, he was going through his own in the last 7 days of the Passion Week. Okay, so vote short, 231 AD, that's the time of the Severan persecution. This was when the Roman Catholic Church actually rose. I did a bunch of videos on that using a book that's a dissertation by a guy named Stephen Williams called Bishops' Lists. It's in my PopeMyth.htm webpage, and the videos are in PopeMyth in YouTube. Starting in 215, there was this gambit by a guy named Demetrius of Alexandria, who was jealous of Origen, and Origen was beginning to get the ear of the Severan Mothers. That's why Paul's using the word mousterion. It's a synonym for being pregnant. Okay? The mystery of the baby inside the mother, okay? He's playing a game here. And you see him do that in Ephesians 3 when he uses the term mystery, which really means a doctrine known only to those inside the group. Okay, but the mothers are behind the throne. So he's making this little play on motherhood controlling the strings behind the throne, okay, at the time. All right? Because he's mapping year by year the Roman Empire. He's also mapping the rise of the Roman Catholic Church, and this is the first time that Peter gets put on a pope list. And that was the subject of the Bishop's List book that was a dissertation by Stephen Williams that I happened to find at Amazon at the time I was researching this thing in Paul. Okay, so by the time Paul gets to what we call AD 231, and it is our AD, that's what shocks me. That's when the Severan persecution began, and the links to the Roman historians and stuff like that are here in the Ephesians 1 reparse doc. Okay, I did not expect Peter to be playing on it, and I still don't know why he's doing it, but he's doing it. See, right here. See, the parallel is to Daniel 9, 24 through 27. Which is the 490, the decree of the 490. There was no human king that decreed the rebuilding of Jerusalem. It was God in Daniel 9:24. I don't know if scholars can be stupider. Okay? The king doing the decree is God in Daniel 9:24, and the decree was in Jeremiah 25, which Daniel was reading at the time he writes Daniel 9. I'm sorry. I mean, 2,000 years of theology, we should be farther ahead in it than still arguing over what Daniel 9 means. Golly. 231 syllables God uses to reply to Daniel. Mary deletes 14 of those from the Magnificat on purpose, because by the time she goes and by the time Christ is 56, those 14 are not yet going to be used up. Okay? Paul plays it both ways, but here he's including it because he's telling you when it gets fulfilled. For church. And that was what we just saw here during the time of the Severans. Sorry it's taking so long. Okay. Right here. Okay. 231 to 238. Okay, is when the tribulation for church begins. It's not the official tribulation, it's the church's own thlipsis. There's a parallel always being established, and that's why Daniel's being paralleled. Okay, by Paul, and now I should be killed. Somebody should kill me. I shouldn't be allowed to live. And now by Peter. Now, is Peter therefore telling us that his meter is at 231 AD and he too is going future? Because if that were true, then he's benchmarking different years in history, not really that far different from Paul. Because Paul benchmarked the Bar Kokhba rebellion in 132. 140 was when Aeolia Capitolina and the pig temple had replaced. So is he getting prophetic too? Because it's in 140 AD that the pig temple replaced the temple, and that's what Peter's whole theme is on the temple. Okay, we saw that here. 84:7 dates back to the rebuilding when, you know, Haggai 2, when God says start rebuilding the second temple, the foundation alone is laid, stop being so lazy. Okay, and 84 years prior to when Peter writes is when Herod started rebuilding the temple. Basically what Herod had done was he built around the second temple foundations and then demolished everything of the second temple and replaced it with his own stuff. If you looked at the link in my the first of these videos on Peter's meter, I provided you with links so that you could read that yourself. In 18 BC, that's what he did. Okay, he hired like 10,000 workers, depending on who you talk to, and actually replaced the second temple with his own stone. Okay, so Peter's deliberately tying to the temple when he does this. The second temple, when it begins to be rebuilt, and when Herod began to replace the second temple with his own rebuilding. Because basically he's saying, high temple's going to go down and it needs to be rebuilt. Okay, and then it's rebuilt again, hello, as a Roman pig temple in 140. Hadrian had died just before. Hadrian was the one who ordered it. It was a result of Bar Kokhba, and that new temple was a pig temple to Zeus or something. And the whole city was renamed Aeolia Capitolina, and the Jews weren't allowed to be in it except on 9th Ave. Is this too clever for words or what? See why I think God should kill me? I don't think I ought to be able to live. This is too much knowledge for a human being to have. Or I certainly don't, I shouldn't be allowed to know. I'm too crappy a person. Somebody better than me should get this. That's why I'm making a video, because you're better than me. I shouldn't know this alone. It's not fair. Sorry. Okay. I apologize for not being able to have enough emotional control. Okay. 231, therefore, is very evocative because Daniel 9, 24 through 27 is God's meter back to Daniel on the 490. 231 AD is when the Severan persecution started, and it was the impetus for it was the meddling Catholics. Demetrius meddling with Origen meddling with the Severans, and then you had Hippolytus get involved and another guy named Julius Africanus. They were all trying to convert the Severans. And the Roman factions inside the temple didn't like the mothers to start with. The mothers were listening to these newly christened Catholics. They used Catholic for the first time then. Okay? They didn't like it, so they started persecuting her. Hippolytus got banished. Julius Africanus, Hippolytus, I think, got killed. No, the guy that Hippolytus in Rome was supporting, a bishop in Rome who called himself Catholic for the first time. Hippolytus supported him. That bishop got killed. Hippolytus got banished. I don't know what happened to Africanus. And Origen went, I think, back to, I don't know, wherever it was, Caesarea. All right? So the whole thing scattered in the Severan persecution starting in 231 A.D., So Peter looks like he's referring to history the way Paul did. So then what that means, if we're following the same methodology we had to use for Paul, then Peter is making a statement about the character of the time between when he writes in 66 AD and 140 AD. See, he's playing the 84 both ways. And maybe that's why John picks up the 84 in Revelation, to say that, yeah, what Peter wrote is happening on time, tying back to both Peter and Paul's prophetic satire. This is a prophetic satire on Rome and on Christians being apostate. See, Pig Temple. 140 AD, Pig Temple's going to be there. Okay? My machine is starting to go wacko, and so am I. So, you know, have a look at that. Think it over. Have a look at Ephesians 1 Reparsed. I'll put a link in the video description. And I'll try to get better composure and talk about this again later. Peace out.